Law enforcement agencies across the country have been buying data in a piece of software which says it can give them the power to track the movements of 250 million Americans.
We all want to be able to use the internet without feeling like someone's watching over our shoulder. Privacy is essential for a free society because surveillance leads to a chilling effect where people's actions can not only be targeted and controlled by others, but people start to self-censor, no longer feeling free to make their own choices because of the feeling that they're being monitored. Privacy and security on the internet starts with your router because it's the gateway to all your online activity. But unfortunately, regular router software and firmware is notoriously insecure. Consumer-grade routers are like leaky boats.
There's a leak in the boat!
In previous videos, we've recommended beefing up your router by using open source software called pfSense. It's incredibly powerful software that gives you granular control over your internet settings so that you can go even further to protect your online privacy and security. Our previous video in this home network series focused specifically on DNS, which is like the phone book of the internet that translates domain names to IP addresses so that your computer can connect to them. DNS is a huge privacy leak on the internet, allowing your ISP, governments, or basically anyone snooping on your traffic to see everywhere you go online. So we showed you how to set up pfSense to handle your DNS requests and how to tweak your settings so that you can patch this big privacy hole. This video is an addendum to our previous video because the thing with pfSense is that while the granular control makes it really powerful, it can also be confusing. We wanted to make a video diving into the DNS resolver on pfSense and explaining what each of the settings means so that you can get a better understanding of just what it's capable of. And we chatted to John Todd from Quad9 to help with this process. So let's get stuck into it. The specific local DNS resolver software that we recommend is called Unbound, and it's third-party software within pfSense designed to provide more robust and secure DNS services that give us more control over our network. To find your Unbound settings, go to Services and select DNS Resolver. DNS Resolver is the code name for Unbound within pfSense. Under the General Settings tab, you'll see a box that says Enable DNS Resolver.
That enables Unbound to start working on your pfSense box.
Next in the settings, you'll see the Listen port. Network ports are like channels on a computer that network services use to communicate. This Listen port is the network port that your DNS Resolver is listening to for incoming connections. By default in your settings,
Listen port is 53,
which is the standard network port used by DNS services. When a device on your network wants to look up a domain name like www.brave.com, it sends a DNS query to your DNS resolver on port 53, and you've set Unbound to listen for incoming requests on that port.
Most DNS queries are unencrypted, meaning that the client can send us things with UDP on port 53, just in the clear.
UDP is just the standard protocol for sending short messages like DNS requests across the network. While port 53 is unencrypted, which means that anyone on your network can intercept your DNS requests, it is possible to use something called DNS over TLS.
Enable SSL or TLS service? That's basically saying, will Unbound communicate in an encrypted way to the clients inside your house? And you probably don't need to do that.
If you and your family are the only ones on your local network, you wouldn't consider it a hostile network where you'd need to encrypt everything. So most people can just ignore this. Plus, turning it on opens a whole other can of worms.
You need to get a valid certificate and do a whole bunch of other things. SSL TLS certificate should be web configurator default.
SSL TLS certificates are used to secure communications between your web browser and a server. In this case, with your web browser and the pfSense web configurator program. But again, because you're probably not encrypting this local traffic within your network, this isn't something that you have to worry about.
SSL TLS listen port should be 853, but we're not using that since we're not actually enabling TLS.
This is the default port for encrypted DNS queries that use TLS. Then we have the network interfaces options. These will list all the different segmented networks being handled by pfSense. For example, in my home network, I have different networks separated by firewall rules to silo things like IoT devices away from my important devices. If you want your DNS settings to apply to all of your networks, then
network interfaces should be all.
Then there's outgoing network interfaces.
That means where is Unbound going to appear to originate queries outbound to Quad 9, and you want to have that be your WAN interface.
Because the WAN interface is the only one that can talk to the internet.
Strict outgoing network interface bindings should not be selected.
This setting is helpful for more complex setups, where you might want more control over which network interface is used for outgoing connections. It can also be useful for privacy or security reasons, where you want to ensure that certain traffic always goes out of a particular interface. But you should only use this if you really understand your network configuration, because misconfiguration will lead to some real headaches.
System domain local zone type is transparent.
This setting is for people who have a local domain set up. For example, your router might use .local or .lan as a default local domain. This would allow you to access devices on your network via a name rather than an IP address. It's used with more complicated setups, and most users have no need for a local domain. But if you do have a local domain set up, transparent means Unbound will answer DNS queries for records that it has local data for, like hosts on your local network, and forward all other queries for that domain to the upstream DNS servers.
DNSSEC is no or unclicked. DNSSEC is actually a rather clever way of ensuring that the DNS answers that you are receiving from the very far end, from all the way from the authoritative server, are in fact the answers that that server says are true. It doesn't encrypt it, but it creates a signed model of trust where you can say, I'm making sure, completely making sure that the answers that were originated all the way out there on the distant part of the internet, the ones that I'm getting, are true, because otherwise this encryption model would tell me otherwise. So DNSSEC is a way of preventing people from trying to inject false answers. It prevents people from spoofing answers to you. And so you can turn that on and Unbound will do it. It's not necessary if you're using Quad 9 because we do that checking for you. We will actually validate DNSSEC on our side. There is no harm in doing it on your side, though. You can set it either way. It's slightly slower to turn on DNSSEC.
So you can choose whether you want that on or off.
Python module.
Unbound has an option for allowing Python scripting to handle DNS requests, which can be useful for more complex scenarios. Using it requires a good understanding of both Python programming and DNS. So for most people,
leave that turned off.
This next setting, DNS query forwarding, is an important one.
You definitely want DNS forwarding turned on. Instead of Unbound doing all this recursive work for you, it's going to forward the queries to the DNS servers you set in the general configuration options.
Our previous video on DNS shows you how to set this so that your queries are sent to Quad 9. The benefits of this are that Quad 9 helps filter out malicious traffic for you, and they hide your DNS queries so that authoritative servers can't see what you're requesting, mixing queries in with millions of other users. You can watch our previous video for how to set that up. But another really important thing that Quad 9 does is allow you to encrypt your DNS queries from your device to the upstream resolver.
Use SSL TLS for outgoing DNS queries to forwarding servers. Yes, you want to turn that on as well. That means encrypt the connection between Unbound and Quad 9.
Quad 9 is one of the few major resolvers that actually supports this encrypted connection between your local resolver and their upstream resolver.
The session is encrypted, so no one can see where you're going or what you're doing with the DNS.
This even stops your ISP seeing your DNS requests, which is super important because they're notorious for selling this data. Next,
DHCP registration.
This is basically where you can find devices in your home network using assigned names instead of just their IP addresses.
Do you have local devices that you want to refer to by name and have those show up in your configuration settings? Let's say you gave your phone the name iPhone 1. On your laptop, could you say ping phone 1, and would pfSense know to look up the name phone 1 in the DHCP leases instead of going out and trying to resolve it through on the internet? It's a way of inserting local names into the DNS so that you can manage them locally. Most people don't need to do that. I usually leave that as set to off because I don't necessarily care what the names are that DHCP leases use. It doesn't hurt to have it turned on or off. Same thing with the next line, static DHCP. registers DHCP static mappings in the DNS resolvers. When you set up a DHCP server to say, all right, when I turn my phone on in my house and it talks to pfSense and it gets an IP address, does it get the same IP address every time, or does it get a different IP address every time? You can set a static IP address so that every time you turn your phone on, pfSense says, oh, your phone is turned on. I see the MAC address of the phone. I'm going to give it this IP address, and I'm going to give it this name.
You can either turn that on or off.
OpenVPN clients. OpenVPN is a way of actually treating pfSense as a VPN concentrator.
When you set this up, you're making sure that
when you're away from your home, the device you happen to be carrying is communicating over a secured channel back into your home. When you're on the road, if you want to have your phone talk back to pfSense as a VPN destination so that it appears your phone is in your home, you can set that up. pfSense will act as a VPN service provider.
This particular setting, the register connected OpenVPN client in the DNS resolver, means that if you have multiple devices using this VPN service,
you probably want to give them names so that you can identify them. So do you want to register those OpenVPN names so that you can locally resolve them instead of sending the queries out to the global internet where those names probably don't exist? If you're not using OpenVPN, you can just ignore this. Display custom options, don't worry about that. Custom options right now should be blank.
This feature is intended for advanced users who are familiar with Unbound's configuration syntax and need to specify options that are not available through the pfSense user interface. That's a basic overview of all the Unbound DNS resolver settings. One final clarification to be aware of. As mentioned, the Unbound settings are found under Service and DNS Resolver. DNS Resolver is a code word for the Unbound program, which is what we're using as our local DNS resolver. But there is another settings page under Services and DNS Forwarder. DNS Forwarder is actually a code word for the DNS Mask program, which is a lightweight tool designed to provide DNS and optionally DHCP to a small network. We recommend that you don't use this program and instead use the more feature-rich and sophisticated program Unbound, which is a full-fledged recursive caching DNS resolver. pfSense is a great tool that gives your router a power up, enabling greater control, enhancing security, and giving you the ability to set up more privacy for your internet activities. It can be complex to navigate, but you don't need to understand what every little toggle does in order to get immediate benefits. It's definitely worth exploring pfSense and learning how to make your internet activity more private. In our next video in this series, we'll dive into DNS block lists so that you can stop your computer from connecting to sites that serve ads, track you, or host malware. And it can also stop your computer from sending out a bunch of telemetry about your usage. As always, this video wasn't sponsored by anyone, and we have no partnerships that we're promoting. NBTV is actually a nonprofit that is funded by community donations. If you'd like to support our free educational content, please visit nbtv.media/support. We also have a book, Beginner's Introduction to Privacy, that also supports our channel. Also, just liking, sharing, and commenting on our videos really helps. Thank you so much for watching through to the end, because that also really helps too.